Hi Harpers, it's Tiffany Schaefer with TiffanyHarpAndSong.com. I'm here to empower you to arrange and play Celtic music, and in that spirit, in this month, we have a Manx tune called The Sheep Under the Snow. It's a beautiful song, and make sure you check the description, click show more, because I'm going to have some links down there with some lyrics and actually some sheet music in another key that I found, if you'd like to sing it. This key is not so great for singing, but make sure you click the link down there. There is a whole other version and you can read the English words. If you'd like to get my arrangement of this, you can also check the description down below. I've arranged this for pretty easy, the first verse through, and then we go into more of an intermediate advanced version. The easy one also fits on a small harp very well. And if you'd like the full length tutorial for this song, which teaches you how to play my whole arrangement as well as tips and tricks and technique and other ideas, I have a very big announcement. You can get the full lesson for download now and keep it on your device for life. So make sure you click show more, or if you're on a phone, that little arrow in the right on underneath this video, and everything you need to know will be down there. Good news, if you get it soon, you won't be charged as soon as you pledge. You'll only be charged on the 1st of March. And you can also download January's tutorial as well. So I'm going to play for you my arrangement now. We're in the mode of a Dorian, which is technically like A minor, except with F sharps. But if you don't have levers, all you need to do is tune up this one F, which is two Fs above middle C, and tune that to sharp. You won't need to change it throughout the whole piece. That's all you'll need. Otherwise, we'll have no sharps or flats. Okay, so I'm going to go over the bare bones simple melody first, and then we'll talk about ornaments, melodic variations, my arrangements, how to play those, what to do if you have a small harp. So check below for timestamps, or if you're downloading this from Patreon, you'll have a sheet of timestamps to download. So we're going to start with 3-2-1 on ABC, easy enough to remember. I'm going to play the first phrase and then we will dissect it. So we're just going to play 3-2-1. Now, if you want to hook these phrases together, you can make sure that your third finger is on that E. It's a sixth apart before your thumb leaves the C. Let's practice this phrase a few times. I should mention this is on a pickup, so your first two notes will be a pickup. One, 2, 3. One more time. And then our next phrase is going to be a crab shape, right? We're going to go from the bottom up. So it will be D, E, and we're going to skip the F. So just listen to how that sounds. And play it on your harp and see if it sounds the same. We're going to wait a little while on that E. Just give it a little hair of a beat. So let's try that again for the whole phrase together. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2. 3, 3, there you go. So if you need to pause that and go over it again, that's fine, and then I'm going to move on to the next phrase. Here it is so you can hear it. So this time we're going to start with an okay shape. We're going to start from the A, the G, and then we're going to skip the F again. One right after the other. And then we're going to hop our thumb all the way up to the E of the octave. Two E's. D, E. So E, E, D, E. Let's try that again from the OK shape. If you don't know what shapes I'm talking about, I will put a link below to Carol Coppice's video. Okay, so here it is in time. I will snap my fingers so you get the sense of it. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so let's put that together with the first phrase. Here we go. 3, 2, 1 from the A. A new phrase. I'm going to play it for you first. So we're going to have another little stack of three, starting from the E this time all the way up to G. Put your second finger back on F before you play your thumb, and then put your thumb back on G before you play the F, because you're going to go back and forth. And this time, your second finger will go to the E. So let's do just that much again. Stack from E, F, G. So one more time. Put your thumb back, second on E. Okay, after that, we're gonna have a whole new shape. That's the okay shape again. We're going to skip the C this time. E, D, and skip C, and play the B. So we do have two E's in quick succession. One of them is going to be played with our second finger. One of them is going to be played with your thumb. So let's try that again from the stack. Try and place all three of those at once. Great. So I'm going to show you the next phrase, and then we'll do all four of them together, or from the beginning. Here it is. So we just have one G there. This is probably the most difficult in the whole song. The few ways you could do the fingering here, I think this is makes the most sense. We're going to start with 2-1 on GB. Okay, and I've put in the sheet music, I've put X's where you're going to cross over or cross under, so you can let me know if you like that. we're going to cross the thumb right over there to the G. So one more time. The 2 is on G, 1 is on B. And before you play the A, your thumb will go to G, where your second just was. So get used to that. So after that, now we have a new shape. We have that crab shape again, skipping the F. Before you play the D, go ahead and put your second finger back on E. And before you play the E, go ahead and put your thumb back on G. So just that much. From the G, B, here we go. 1, 2. And the final thing I want you to do is before you play that thumb, actually bring your second finger back under to the A. So it looks just like this after 2. 1, 2. Once you get that down, it's nice and smooth feeling. Great, so let's play this from the beginning. This is basically the A part, like the verse part, and then the chorus comes later, which is very similar. But let's go from the beginning of this. Remember that part? All right, I'll count us in 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Here's the okay, all the way up to the E, 2 E's. Here's the stack from E to G. The okay, here's the turnaround one. Great, so go over that again, pause the video if you need to. And then we're going to come back and learn the chorus part, sort of the B part of the tune. We're going to start with 3, 2, 1 on, again, ABC. Here's the first phrase. All right, so I'll teach this one to you. I've put a thumb slide in here because it just feels most comfortable to me. You don't have to, but I'll show you how to do it. We'll start with ABC. And we're going to cross, right before we play that one, cross your 2 just to the next string over on D. And then your thumb will end up on E. So we're encompassing an A fifth with that, from the A to the E. Now we can play C and the E. But as we play the E, we're not going to close our thumb. It's the only time I'll tell you not to close your thumb, right? If you're doing this or glissandos or something. It's really a very short glissando is what a thumb slide is. It only encompasses like 2 or 3 strings. So we're going to start with second on C, and then we're going to just play the E as we slam our thumb into the D. And then you're going to place a G triad and go down. So again, that maneuver is... Don't be too stiff while you're doing it. Just try to make it feel natural. You'll find those in Celtic music sometimes, those thumb slides, especially for some fast tunes. Can help you out a little bit. If you don't want to do that, then I would suggest something like... two, one, two, three, four. But this just feels very natural to me, so that's why I put it in. Okay, so from the beginning of that phrase,
E to the, or A to the E. One, two. So now we're going to start again that same walk up from the A. Now, I originally had this fingered as 4, 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, so you ended up on your thumb, but I found that I kept putting my third finger on the A because that's what I had been doing in other spots. So I think it's easier to just go ahead and keep your third finger on that A. This time we're going to go all the way up to the G. 3, 2, 1, and then go ahead and put 3 on the D before you play that 1. And before you play that one on the F, bring your second to the G. So again, here's the timing for this. You gotta leave those little beats in between. So I will count us in on the sheet music. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and 1, and 2, and 3, and 1, and 2, and that's how it goes. Then we just have one more phrase to do, really. It's the same one that we just did with thumb slide. Remember that? We just did it. And then we're going to have a new ending. Very similar to the ending of the verse. This is just slightly different. You start from a different spot. You start from the C this time. So we're going to try 1, 2, 3. Cross your thumb to the G before you play the 3. And then we have that crab shape again. Skip the F. Go back up and cross. So your second finger's on A. That is the whole tune. So let's play that B part again. From there. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And 1. 3 this time. Same one. Cross. Great. Let's play the whole melody. 1, 2, 3. We'll come in on the pickup. 1, 2, 3. Stack from E. Second on E now. Okay shape. Cross. And here's the slide. Three under this time. Here's the slide. Now we start from C. Alright, well done. So let's talk about the great ornaments and variations you can do with this melody, and then we'll get into the arrangements. I hope you enjoyed this sample lesson and this gets you started. If you again would like the full tutorial where I take you through all of the left-hand stuff and ornaments and practice and technique tips, you can get that in the description. Just click show more and you can download that via Patreon. Now, I taught this to you in A Dorian so that you could play along with a very special video which is coming along next week, and I'll put it right here when it's ready.
And if you would like to learn more tunes, you can just click this playlist right here. Make sure that you subscribe so that you don't miss next week's very special video. And I will catch you next time. Bye-bye.